Hey, in this video, I want to talk about why the I am practice is more important than any other. And it's a practice that you're likely familiar with if you're into non-duality and on the spiritual awakening path. And potentially, if you're like me, you've appreciated it and understood it, and it's had varying degrees of relevance throughout your journey, but you also take it for granted until you don't. And it would seem apparently here that that's the experience, that there is not only a not taking it for granted anymore, seeing that it was taken for granted, and now really relying on it above anything else in terms of deepening this. So I guess to relate my own experience recently as today, and you know, I would just say, like, even in the past months and especially years and throughout my whole life, I've been burnt by the dream, and you know, to varying severities, some first degree, some third degree, and worse. Most recently it has been pretty minor, but the interesting thing about the mind and the dream is that you can burn yourself a lot and continue to go back and get burnt more. And in fact, you can actually grow addicted to getting burnt by the dream. And that is what happens to a large majority of people, unbeknownst to them. In an unconscious way, they continue to go and put their hand on the hot stove because, as awful as it is, there's actually some pleasure derived out of the pain. And they, on the deepest level, grow addicted to the rush of hormones and chemicals, which of course is all imaginary, but nevertheless, the experience that ensues when getting burnt. And I'm using getting burnt as a metaphor, because it isn't just like actually getting burnt, but it's like, you know, investing too deeply in narratives of the dream. Finding yourself, just got done working out, so a lot of congestion right now. Finding yourself in situations where you are stressed or upset or having to go let the dog back in because she wanted to come out and now she doesn't want to stay out here. I'm in the stairwell. That wouldn't be a burn, but finding yourself in situations where, yet again, you invest yourself, you know, in an unconscious way, more substantially than you would if you were conscious. And that can be anything: relationships, careers, shopping, deciding what to watch, deciding what to do, you know, believing yourself to be a person, et cetera, et cetera, are all ways in which the dream hooks us and we, you know, fall asleep into it. And then if we have no experience relative to spiritual awakening, you know, most of us, or many of us, which I guess I shouldn't say is us, because most of us who are here on this channel do have a lot of experience with it, but those that we see around us, you know, then self-medicate or, you know, wind up digging themselves deep into a rut. They break their back. They induce a ton of, you know, self-induced suffering and and grinding to try to save a sandcastle that was destined to crumble. And so, you know, those of us who are on this path, however, have discovered and have really remembered, recognized that what was so obvious all along, that the dream was never going to get us anywhere, that the dream is constantly disappearing on us, and it's got an infinite level of unpredictability and unreliability. And no matter how much reinforcement we put into that sandcastle, the waves knock that sucker over, or slowly erode it, or a blend of both, inevitably always. And so eventually that gets exhausting, and so we seek, you know, a way to solve for it, and, you know, maybe wind around all sorts of different things, medications, psychology, psychotherapy, self-help, and eventually spirituality. And then those of us who have made it to the non-dual or Advaitin or, you know, basically any sort of teachings around truth, that this is a spiritual experience and that there is no material element of it, just the illusion of that, are then wound up ultimately and eventually realizing the importance of the simplicity that I am brings and the power that I am has. So I am is not about saying I am, though it is a helpful thing to chant and to use as an anchoring tool, but it's about abiding. It's about re-situating yourself, re-centering yourself as what you are, as the self, recognizing that you are that which is. You are the supreme. You are that which is aware. Everything else comes and goes. And what it's also about is training the mind, showing the mind, redirecting the mind back to its source, conditioning, reconditioning the mind to hair stuck on my phone that was catching the mind's attention. Reconditioning the mind to stop thinking. Because thinking is what creates so much turbulence, you might say, so much, you know, wildly varied vibration, and inevitably leads to a point where it has to settle, either through sleep, death, or meditation. And I am is meditation. Life is meditation. Existence is meditation. But thinking is an illusory phenomena that veils meditation, which is, you know, not quite accurate, because meditation is, awareness is, but thought clouds it, like my snow globe pointer that I posted the other day. So what then becomes abundantly clear is that every time the mind wanders, it needs to be brought back to rest. Every time the mind begins to think, it needs to be reminded of its source. There will not be anything in the dream that will derive any sort of lasting value whatsoever. And the mind will try to convince you otherwise, but if you burn yourself enough times, you figure out that it won't, that it can't, that it's a waste of your time. And it doesn't mean that you stop living life, But the thing is you were never living life in the first place. Life was living itself. Life has always been just dreaming itself. Life is just a dream. So the I am practice helps the mind to come back to its source, come back to the center, the centerless center, and recognize much more deeply that this is just a dream, that it was always just a dream. And just like a dream that you have at night, it's perfectly harmless. You have it, it can be harrowing, wonderful, whatever, and then you wake up from it and it's over and it's gone and you let it go and that's that. And that's this, that is this experience, and that's what this always has been and always will be. It's just up to you to see that and then to stop investing in it. And that doesn't mean that it stops, but it means that you stop suffering in it. You stop thrashing about in it. You stop investing in it. And you train the mind to come back to the source and do that above all else. Treat that practice as the most important. And eventually you won't need any practice because the mind will just naturally stay present. Because that's all that this is presence. It's I am, here I am, I am. I am. The mind starts to wander. I am. As soon as you notice it, I am. Who's aware of this wandering? Who's aware of this appearances? Who's aware of these sensations? I am. And the mind will then reveal to you just how dreamy this is. And there's nothing left but to be happy and at peace, no matter what happens, because you recognize that no matter what happens, it's just a dream. It's disappearing on you. The sand castle is crumbling and dissolving back into the ocean, back into the sea. So that, my friends, is why the I am practice is the most important of all. I wish you well and look forward to catching up with you soon. Peace.